this slide. So we are already in theories, no, of learning. So we'll be discussing the different framework and models that may guide us as we go about with our teaching and learning activities or process in the classroom, no, especially if you are already in the field. So remind na kita ko class kay sa VLE maging post ako dito nga project ninyo na about sa e-portfolio, okay? So again, ginaklaro ko lang pwede ka mo maka-use sang any applications that will enable you to create a video. Pwede ka mo kagamit sang PowerPoint, you save it as a video, no, file. You save, change yung inyong file name sa MP4. Okay, kay dumasula sang PowerPoint. Pwede ka select ka mo sang pictures nga best nga maka-help sa aton nga teaching and learning. Mga digital and non-digital tools. Tapos, i-describe yun na siya based sa rubric na ginahatag ko basahon yung man to. Amo to akong basayan sa pag-check. Because that is your major project, tani, sa midterm, galing wala ka ma-realize kay na-run out of time kita. And that's why subong ubrahon nyo na, ha? Kay expect ko na sa inyo. Idugan ko na sa midterm ninyo nga grade. Okay, so without much ado, let's move on. Again. Nag-ubo lang ako. So, I would like to give to discuss the Edgar Dale's cone of experience, okay? So, paano ni siya maka-help sa aton later sa classroom, sa pedagogy ta, no, sa aton nga teaching and learning process. So, the cone of experience give us idea about what are being considered in the teaching, no, and learning process of our students. So, we can see here the degree of abstraction as to how the student will learn, no, the kind of activities or strategies that we may apply in order for the students to learn, no, the subject matter in the classroom. So we have here the direct purposeful experiences, amugin ang pinaka concrete, no, nga level sang abstraction. We also have this what we call contrived experiences, dramatized experiences, demonstration, field trips, exhibits, motion pictures, audio recordings, photos, pictures, visual symbols, text, verbal symbols. So they said, it says that the more senses that we touch in the classroom, the more learning that take place, something like that. Okay, kumbaga kung makita mo, no, kung makita mong isang bagay, so 10% of what you read or what you see, you will remember or you will learn, okay? And 20% of what you hear, okay, the mas powerful yung ang mabatian, no, kaysa sa mabasa, the mas guarding sa aton memory, you will remember that or you will learn that. If it is also video or mga images, no, 30% of what you see, you can remember. No, but if it is, example, exhibits or mga sites, demonstration, that's 50% of what they see and hear, they can remember. No, our students can remember. Learners can remember. If it is participation, mga hands-on activities, mga workshops, design collaborative lessons, 70% of what they say and write, no, they learn from it. And if it is simulation, model, or experience a lesson, design, perform a presentation, do the real thing, that's 90% of what they do. They learn 90% of what they do. That's why, kumbaga, ang pinakatakugid nga contribution, kumbaga, sa learning of students are this level of abstraction, the what they do. Okay? Bisan ka mo man, no? Batian ko na ganang familiar nga, I don't know if it is a saying or statement nga, teacher, the best teachers are experience, or experiences are best teachers, or experience is the best teacher, if you would agree, no? So, amo man na, no? Sa, doon nag-support siya sa cone of experience ni Dale, no? Edgar Dale, okay? So, let's try to understand deeper, no? So, again, when we see text or verbal symbols, amo na siya mga examples ng mga libro nga mabasa mo, mga symbols, okay? So, amo na siya class sa top, okay? Sa highest level. But it doesn't mean highest level siya. Ang muna ang pinaka Okay? Yung kumbaga pinakagamay nga, nga makakontribute sa memory or learning sa bata compared sa iba no, nga experience. Next, we have picture or visual symbols. Okay, ang second sa from top. Next, we have audio recording or photos. That's why yung mga teachers ninyo gagamit siniklas, no? Ang iban, gapahulas na lang mga text lang, no? Sa verbal symbols, mga ano sang lawas, mga gina express sang lawas ng mga signs, something like that, or baba, no, mama na, or mga ano na, tumula, mga, tawag ka na, mga symbols, ah, mga signs. Mas ma-learn mayad, no, compared sa libro lang class or mga PDF file lang gina-share sa inyo, mas I think better if video na siya ang gina-share or ginagamit yung mga material because there are more senses that can be touched, na meaning mas ma-learn nyo, no, ang content. So, that's also, especially kung virtual na siya. Okay, kay wala mo kita masyado face-to-face ng experience or physical experience, so doon din natin ma-realize ning sa dalom nga portion nga dapat ada kagi sa actual. But you can do that by yourself, no, ang actual experience. Okay, next we have the motion picture. Syempre, mas gusto nato ng gahulag-hulag. Do dali kinato na siya ma-retain sa atong memory kung tumatandaan, no, kung motion gaga move, no, moving it ang element, no. Exhibits. Okay, I think you have experienced this. That's why ginapalantaw kamo sa mga exhibits or even kamo ang ga-exhibit kamo mismo, ga-perform sa activity, no. Nagkakandak sa exhibit. Next, field trips, no. I think I'm sure na experience niyo sa high school or elementary because of the real life, kumbaga sa experience, nagkatuka mo sa mga nga lugar, do mas maintindihan mo, no, kung ano ang story sa mga nga lugar, ano ang iyang ang scenario sa mga nga lugar, ma-recall mo, kumbaga. That's why ginapa-experience ka mo sa ginatawag na field trips or educational trips because you will learn, no, more by that. Hindi lang kung nga video lang or audio lang or text lang, blackboard lang, kaglibro, no. That's why ibagid man kung kamo later magamit yung man i-perform yung manis inyong mga students. Next, we have this what we call demonstration. Okay, so gina-demonstrate ni ma'am sa science kung paano mag-mix ang chemical, paano mag-perform sa activities, paano mag-demo kung paano mag-teaching demonstration, experience nyo sa Pilakadlao, no, para mapakita nyo, no, kung ma-experience nyo, no, ma-learn nyo, ay, kulang ako sa amusin ni, amo pa ni-improve ko, okay? Or pwede man dramatize kamo or playing kamo sa klase, no? So by that you will really understand the role of a character that you play or a situation that you are in that particular drama or in that particular role playing activity. Next, we have this what we call na-mention ko na dramatize nan. So aside from the demonstration, no, iba man si dramatization sa demonstration. Demo ya ginasunod ka, no, gina-perform mo kung paano na siya. Pero kung dramatized experience, sila gid mismo, kamo mismo, ang nag-perform, okay, sang amo na nga character. Okay? Next, we have contrived experiences. Ang real life na giniya class, no, maginapakadto kamo sa science laboratory, ang tawon nyo to kung ano ang tsura sang amo ni nga microorganism, amo ni nga sang sample, sang stages, sang feet, sang fetal development, no, something like that, no, amo man ni. Okay, so you will see the actual face or the reality, pero hindi pa gina siya amo, something like that. That's what we may be contrived experiences. Next, direct or purposeful experiences. So, kamo mismo ang ka-perform. Okay, amo ni siya class kina-required sa kada program, sa kada course, ang ginatawag nga OJT. Because by that experience, ma-actualize mo na gid sa class ang imo nga mga learning. Kag you will learn more kung ano pa gid ang dapat nga i-improve mo para ma-achieve mo ang ina-expect, no, nga competency, no, knowledge and competence, no, nga dapat may ara ka before you go to that particular field of work, okay? So gina-perform ka mo, no, because by that mas ma-learn nyo ang mga topic ta or ang mga bagay-bagay nga gina-discuss or mga parts ng aton objective sa klase or sa program. Okay? So that's what we mean by direct or purposeful experiences. So maobra ka sa IT company, kadto ka sa IT company, maobra ka sa school. Kay mo OJT ka gito, experience mo bitang school, kung ano na siya, ang scenario dira. Okay, ang ara ka na sa sitwasyon nga na. So, that's about, no? That's what we mean by Edgar Dale, Dale's cone of experience. Na gina, respect ni class, okay, which we also consider in developing our lesson planning or lesson management or sa pedagogy ta sa teaching and learning, no? Another, okay, I would like to introduce this to what we call TPAC model. Okay, so what is this TPAC model? So the TPAC model or the TPAC stands for Technological Pedagogical Content Knowledge. It is the combination of the technology, the pedagogy, and the content. Okay, so I would like to discuss more about TPAC. So when we say TPAC, that is a framework that teaches or teachers can use to help them identify knowledge they might need to focus, not to be able to teach effectively with technology. Kumbaga, gina-consider natin diri ang integration of the technology sa classroom. Okay? So, let's be familiar with each of the domain, no, of the TPAC component. So, we have technological knowledge. So, when you say technological knowledge, that's your knowledge and mastery of technology so that an educator can use a confidently plan use of technologies in the classroom, including when it is not required. Okay. Class, about niya sa knowledge ta sa technology, okay? Kabalo ka magamit technology. Ano nga klase ka technology? Okay? Ano nga applications gamiton ta? Paano man? Okay? Amo na siyang ginamatawag ta nga technological knowledge. When you say pedagogical knowledge, that's about your knowledge sa and practice, no? Knowledge and practice of teaching and learning that an educator can use such as a classroom management, taxonomies, planning, and assessment. This is very important, no? Sa teacher. Kay class, may ara nga kabalo sa iyang ginatudlo, pero hindi siya kabalo magtudlo, no? I know, experience, sumaniguro sa iba nyo nga, maybe, no, teachers, pero wala man base, ah. Nabalang sagad-sagad si ma'am o si sir. Pero nagkakandi o kanchindi kung si ma'am kung si sir maklase. Nasagad man ni, no, nga teacher. So, wala, it's because wala siya sa ginatawag nga pedagogy. Wala siya sa amo na nga competence, pedagogical competence, or pedagogical knowledge. So, di siya kabalo kung saan niya na itudlo, paano niya na itudlo, ano nga strategy para ma-learn ina sa students or sa klase. So, that's what we mean by pedagogy. Or, mag-test si ma'am, wala ang iyagin klase, lain sa iyagin test. Nan. Hindi ka reklamo ka mo, unabain yung score. Siyempre, lain gintunan, lain nagawa sa test. So, that's also part of pedagogy. Okay, dapat si ma'am, balaan niya kung ano iya i-test. Okay, kung paano niya na i-test. Para effective ang measure, pag-measure niya sa learning sa iya klase, sa student. Something like that. Because it is a factor of a teaching and learning. Siyempre, ga-affect man na sa students. So, kung nabain yung score, wala na siya na-motivate magtuon. Pag hindi niya mag-get kung ano ang gusto ni ma'am matabo kung anong mga, no, something like that, hindi ma-predict ang ginaano ni ma'am, wala aga bagay sa, ma-feel sa students, no, kung daw wala aga bagay ang ginatest sa gina klase, something like that. So, importante ang ginatawag ng pedagogical knowledge, okay? Next, we have this what we call content knowledge. Of course, importante niya siya. Tanan, importante, no? So, kung kabalo kong magtudlo, but you don't know your content, wala ka kabalo kung ano ang ginatudlo mo, no? Example, major mo be math. Tapos patudloon ka bisang sang science. Di ba hindi ka confident mag-teach? It's because hindi mo na siya linya ang science. Although you know something about science, pero wala ka sang deep knowledge about it because iba ang imo gin prepare, iba imo preparation, iba ang gintunan mo, something like that. Okay, that's why, ang muna gintawag sa content, no? So, hindi na siya magiging effective ang teaching kung si math major patudloon mo sang laing subject kay lain iya ng forte. That's something like that. Okay, so matudlo ko sa laing subject na wala mo masyado, di ka masyado familiar. So, may effect man na siya sa klase-klases, of course, sa students. Okay, kaya basi ko ng lain-lain mo tudlo, sa laing mo tudlo. So, hindi ito mag-learn, no? Hindi ma-address ilang learning needs, something like that. So, that's how important the content knowledge is, no? In teaching and learning. So, now, let's try to understand the combination, no? How we inject or how we integrate the use of the technology in the classroom. So we have here pedagogical content knowledge. Okay, so dapat kabalo si teachers ang iya subject matter and kabalo sa ang iya nga paano i-teach nga ma-learn ni student, no? When we say technological content knowledge, kabalo sa ang iya ginatudlo kag kabalo sa kung ano gamito niya ng technology nga application para ma-teach niya na ang iya nga content. Okay? Ang next is technological pedagogical knowledge, okay? Understanding of how teaching and learning on change when particular technologies are used in particular ways. So, kabalo si teachers ng technology, kagbalaan niya kung saan unya na gamiton. Okay, kaya ang ibang nga teacher, gamit lang ang gamit technology, wala ka sila nanto, hindi man nakinanla ng amusin na nga technology para nga ma-learn ang bata, no? Sang amusin na. Alam nga paggamiton niya yan, paano mag, ano na, paggamiton niya yan, pahimuon niya yung video bata, no? Tapos siya, ang iya, galing nga klase niya about sa pag, ano tawag ka dyan? Pahimuon niya sa pa-vlogon niya ya, pero ang iya nga topic about sa automotive or something like that. Wala balaga saan to? Or gamitan niya sa amon ng application nga hindi man bagay sa mga bata kaya wala sila sa amusin ng available na technology. Nan balang, though, paano lang bala? Wala bala na align mayad, okay? Gamit na siya gamit technology, pero daw wala kasi rin nanto sa klase, something like that. Okay, kung wala sa ginatawag na pedagogical knowledge, si teacher ang gin-apply. So, amo na siya, dapat si teacher kabalo sa technology, kabalo yung balo siya kung ano lang ang klase ka technology gamiton niya sa klase. Okay? So that's about technological pedagogical knowledge. Saan unya nagamiton ng amo ng technology? Ano nga klase ka technology gamiton niya? Okay? So kabalo sina si teacher kung amo na, no? So that's about technological pedagogical knowledge. So now let's move on. Next, we have this what we call technological pedagogical content knowledge. So, combination na ni kasang tatlo. Kompleto na ni siya iya nga domain. So, kabalo si teacher sa technology magamit. Kabalo siya kung saan unya ni si technology gamiton, paano gamiton, okay? Tapos, kabalo siya sa iya ginatudlo. Okay? So, perfect. Amo na siya. So, it can help in the teaching and learning process. So, for sure, or if not, no, si teacher maka-deliver ginisang iya nga klase or lesson effectively. Kung ang tatlo sinika domain na integrate niya. Amo ning ginatawag ta nga TPAC. You have the what we call technological pedagogical content knowledge. Okay, so this framework will guide us in our preparation, no, sa magklase na kita if you are already in the field, no, as future teachers. So i-consider man ni naton kasi hindi lang tumblang kabalo ka lang sa mga content, hindi ka kabalo mong tudlo. Kabalo ka sa technology, hindi ka man kabalo kung saan mo nagamiton. Okay? Or, kabalo ka sa technology, balaan mo kung saan mo gamiton, pero wala ka man kabalo kung ano yung itudlo mo, though wala siya ga-balance. So, at least, we know how to integrate now, no? Because we have this what you call idea of the TPAC framework. Okay. So let's move on. Class, ma-add na ko additional resources because gamay-gamay lang gita ko nung napang-discuss. Okay, maantindihan nyo pag ito better ang TPAC, you know, based sa ihatag kong material later. I-post ko lang sa VLE, no? Please read on that later. So another model is the what we call SAMR model. Okay, so what is this SAMR model? Okay, so we see SAMR, that stands for substitution, augmentation, modification, redefinition. Okay? So how do we make use of the technology, no, to teaching and learning? So ang si substitution, technology acts as a direct substitute with no functional change. Gaan ko kamo later karon. Gina-substitute, no, si technology pero wala man tiging change, no, sa iyang function. Next, augmentation, ginagamit si technology as a direct substitute with functional improvement. May ginlain rin, no? May improve rin. Another is modification. Technology allows for significant task redesign. Gina-redesign yun na, gina-modify. And redefinition. Technology allows for the creation of new task previously unconceivable. Okay, nag-create na kita sa bagong nga task. Mawala sa una, ginagamit.
Ma'am, excuse me, nakamute ka, ma'am.
Thank you, thank you. Nagubo abi ako, ang bako. Kasi mabatian nyo. Thank you, good. So, let's move on. I would like to give you examples no sa substitution abi nga part. Si teacher, a teacher direct students to use Google Earth to locate a place instead of using an atlas. So, I think familiar kam sa atlas, no? Mapa na siya. Okay. Next, di ba usually kauna gagamit na kita sa map or globe na bala, no? Mag-locate sang place. Subong niya si Google Earth na pwede natin magamit, no? Because of the technology. Aralan na sa internet, no? Next, the teacher, si augmentation naman niya, how is augmentation, no? The teacher instructs students to use Google Earth to measure the distance between two places on a map instead of using calipers or simply estimating using the scale. So wala na kita gagamit sang scale, gin-augment na natin, gin-level up na natin aton nga pag ano pag measure nagamit na kita sang Google Earth, no? Kay may ara na da measurement si Google Earth kung pila distance, okay, sang amo ni nga location kay sa amo na. Even sa aton Google Map, mabalaan mo kung pila distance, no? Pila ka kilometer imo nga i-travel para makaabot ka sa amo na nga location, right? So gin-augment na natin. Wala na kita gagamit sa assessment lang or kung ano man da nga classic ang measurement, no? Measuring tool. Next, so what about modification? So example, the class would be instructed to use Google Earth layers to research locations on a map. Okay, so nag-modify na kita, wala na kita nagamit sa kung ano dira, no? As we are used to, nagamit na kita sa technology, no? Gamit na ton si Google Earth layers nga feature para ma-research na ton ang location sa map. And no, the redefinition. A teacher has students use Google Earth to create narrated guide tours of a location which they can share online with other students. Okay, so gin-narrate na no kay sang sanu gina sang previous examples ya naga search lang kamo, naga gamit lang kamo sang features na para mag-measure sang distance. Subog niya maka-add na kamo, wala na sa feature. Okay, wala niyo naging ubra before. Kag wala na diri sa Google Earth, no? Kundi, kamo na mismo madugang sina, okay? Para maka-create kamo sang narrated guide tours of a location. Okay, wala na siya before, something like that. So, that's what we mean by the definition. You create something new, okay? Nga wala na isipan before, nga wala ga exist before, something like that. So, that's about the what we call SAMR, a model which will guide us also, no, in our teaching, no, strategies in the future, teaching and learning process in the future. Okay, so let's move on with another. So this one is the what we call the level of higher order thinking skills. Paano mo mabalaan kung ano nga level ang thinking skills nga may ara ka mo or ano nga klase ka activity or ang ka-task ang gina-perform para ma-identify na you have that following or that particular thinking skills, no? So, let's try to look at the Bloom's taxonomy. I think you've heard of this before. Pero if not, then today is the right time for you to learn, no, the idea, no, of Bloom's taxonomy. So, amo ni siya class ang level, no? There are six levels of higher order thinking skills based on Bloom's taxonomy. So the level one is remembering, okay? Mas-start kita sa naba ang thinking skills, remembering, naba na siya. Ang exam nyo karang ginatag sa inyo, naba na siya nga levels ng thinking skills. Wala ka mo sinaga, panumdumgid mayad, nung gina-remember nyo lang. And hindi ka mo maging, nabalang mambal ka sa isa katawang alam-alam, nagit siya kay soul perfect exam niya, okay? So, depende, no? Depende, may araman nga kapasar sa board. Ay, hindi man sa una mo nakaalam. May araman nga alam-alam, pero wala man nga kapasar sa board. Mga naman, feeling mo alam. Because, ang iya nga thinking skills, daw dira lang sa amo na nga level. Kali, kaya nga gwa sa board exam, mga situational, na require sa sang higher level thinking skills. So, amo na siya klas, ang gusto tama, develop ninyo, no? Sa inyong self, because you will be teachers, no? In the future. So, level one is understand remembering. Okay? Level two, dapat maka may amot siya yung sininga skills, no? May remembering before siya mag-level up. hindi niya ma-understand, no, kung wala siya, hindi niya ma-remember. So level 2 is understanding. Level 3, kung hindi siya maka-understand, hindi man siya maka-apply. Okay? That's why ginanlan si understanding before ang applying ma-achieve. So level 3 is applying. Kumbalaan mo, siyempre ma-apply mo na because you have already understand mo na kung paano na siya i-perform. Then you can perform it. Next, level 4 is analyzing. Kaya na-perform mo na siya, may mga na-experience ka na, no? Ano na next time yung himuon mo para nga ma-avoid mo itong mga problems or mapanami mo imong output or something like that, no? Mag-apply na si analyzing. Next, evaluating. Okay, level 5. Kaya kabalo ka mag-analyze, kabalo ka na mag-decide. Okay, meaning si amo sini, amo ning tsakto, amo ning hindi. I-avoid ko. Something like that. Okay, you can stand. Okay, you can decide. Maka-justify ka na or maka-stand ka na or maka-decide ka na. Next, the highest level is creating. The self-actualize ka na sini. Okay, kaya maka-decide ka na, maka-create ka na sang new nga idea. Okay? Maka-evaluate ka na, no, ah, hindi ko yung magmana, kaya amo sini, kaya amo na siya. That's why amo ni akon gusto bumahon, amo ginadayan bala, no? Or amo ni akon gusto ubrahon nga business. Okay, kaya na test mo na maka-evaluate, maka-decide ka na kung ano. Okay, that's why maka-make ka na sang own mo nga point of view. Maka-make ka na sang own mo nga product or mind, no? Something like that. So that's the highest level of thinking skills. Okay? So these are the things, kumbaga amo ning mga verbs class nga gamiton ta. Ano lang, amo ni ang mga gina-perform nyo. Okay? Ga-perform magi ka mo sini, no? Meaning, kasi na sa amo na nga level. Example, maka-define ka, okay? Maka-list ka, ma-duplicate mo, maka-memorize, recall. Remembering, level 1 na siya class ng thinking skills. Okay? So, tanan ka mo may ara, sina. Otherwise, hindi ka mo kasabas ang test, no? Next, we have understanding. Maka-classify ka, maka-describe, maka-discuss, maka-explain, maka-identify, locate, recognize, report, select, translate, paraphrase. That is level 2. Okay, nga thinking skills. Understanding, maka-meaning nakaintindi ka. If you can do this. Okay? Next, maka-choose ka, maka-demonstrate, dramatize, employ, illustrate, interpret, operate, schedule, sketch, solve, use, write. Meaning, maka-apply ka. Okay? Applying na siya. Level 3 ka na. Next, if you can appraise, compare, contrast, criticize, differentiate, discriminate, distinguish, examine, experiment, question, test, meaning you are in analyzing a level 4 ka. If you can appraise, no, argue, defend, judge, select, support, value, evaluate, that means you are in level 5. You can evaluate. Okay, if you can do this. Okay, may kaiso ka mo mag-argue, ma-defend mo, ma-judge mo, ma-select mo, ma-support mo, okay, ma-value mo, and so on. Next, the highest level is that, can you construct your own idea? You can create. Can you create your own idea? Can you design your own? Can you develop a certain program or whatever it is? Can you formulate? Can you write your own something, story or theory? Okay, or maka-assemble ka sa isa ka machine, technology, product, whatever it is, no? That's already creating. So this is already self-actualization or the what we call highest level of thinking skills. You are already applying the highest level of thinking skills, no? If you're already in this part. So, if you are to consider the technology, no? Let's say to look at the Bloom's digital taxonomy. So, amuni ka sa mga activities, no? With digital tools. Okay? Meaning, kung ka-perform kung sini, para ka na sa amuni nga level of higher order thinking skills. Okay? So, examples. Kung kabalo ka mag-bookmark sa mga website, no? Kung mga ano man na dagi na pang ubra mo sa internet, okay, kung ga-copy ka, copy-paste, ga-highlight, naga-search, then you are already in this, you have this remembering or level 1 thinking skills. Okay, kung gagamit ka sa technology or digital tools. Next, we have ga-journal ka, ga-tweet, ga-tag, ga-subscribe, no? Doga may-ari ka mo sini. Meaning you understand, no? You have this, what you call, understanding thinking skills. You are already in this level, no? Level 2. You are in the level 3 if you can calculate, maka-chart ka, maka-edit, maka-upload. Okay, so tanan ka mo, feeling ko, mara kahit ika-upload ganit ka mo, di ba? Upload ka mo sa inyong mga data sa YouTube, kag sa, I mean, sa Facebook. Next, we have analyzing. So you can perform mind mapping, survey, link, validating. Okay. Next, evaluating. Nag-grade ka mo, nag-test ka mo, nag-post, nag-moderate, no? Kamo ang nag-host o kon nag-facilitate, something like that. So you are already in the evaluating level. Next, if you are blogging, because it's already creating, mag-create ka sa own mo nga content. Nag-film ikaw, mag-create ka sa own mo content. Nag-podcast ikaw, no? Nag-podcasting. Directing, okay? That means you are already in your highest or in this what we call highest level of thinking skills or highest order thinking skills. Okay, so that's about the Bloom's digital taxonomy. Okay, so I hope you've learned a little about the topic, no, each topic. Class, I will again share the content, no, of the topics that I had discussed a little para mas maintindihan niyo kung ano gidni ang amo sinikay. Of course, magwa na sa inyong board exam, please help yourself. No, try also to read more about this. Okay? So, as of now, I would like to check your memory again. No, I would like you again to answer. Share ko lang yung watang link, although parehas man lang. No? So, I received 18 responses, no, sa una tanga ano. Iban. Sige. So, ang amuni nga score nyo class, i-record ko na niha. Hindi nyo na rin pag-share sa wala ka atin sa klase, ha? Kag hindi ko naman pag-record after, no? Okay. So, any questions so far? Before we start? Okay, ma'am. Tambal na ka mong question. Mambal ka mo, ma'am. Wala mo kami katumay ng sindihan. Ano pa lang, wala kami may madumduman yung question. Base amo na. Okay, so, gin-post ko na class sa chat box. Please answer again. After this time, din ako mag-accept siya na anas ang answer. Okay? Hindi nyo makinilan ma-out sa atin. Meet kayo, ma-picture pa ko sa inyo, ha? Inatdumduman ko, ginatandaan ko na balang nag-aaral ng klase ta. So, you can now start answering the same test, no? Kung nagtaas yung score, very good. Ngayon na-learn ka mo. Pero kung nagnaba, do palagpat ang nangin mo, gali eh. Okay. But anyway, ang muna ginatuod mga learning, no? Ang last mga score. Okay, so I'll be waiting for you until 11:30. Then we shall dismiss the class.